Hey guys, good morning. We're starting the day off with organizing a bit. And if you're a larger family, probably not even a larger family, because I found one of my socks that I took the other half of it because I thought this one's all kind of junky anyway, but I thought I'd lost it. It was in Autumn's laundry. I took it and dusted with it the other day when I was cleaning. So now this sock is not going to have a home and will live in the dusting sock pile. But I have this little bin. I got these from Walmart, I believe, for just a couple of dollars. They're stackable. I actually have them over there. They have stuff in them. I got them for my desk area to stack them and put, I don't know, supplies, and I just never really utilized them. So I took one of them. These are all the socks that do not have a home in our house. Look at that. Look how crazy. How many socks, how many pairs there are. Not even pairs. Like, I could match up a whole bunch of these socks together. But everyone's laundry is done, and nobody has any sock leftovers in their drawer missing friends. Even, like, fuzzy socks. Like, where did the socks go? Seriously, I have Emmy's fuzzy sock.
Wait, tons of...
Okay, tons of Autumn's, which Autumn's I can kind of understand because they're super tiny, but I mean, what the heck? Maddie has like zero socks in her thing. She has lost all of them, and I think actually what happens...
Fuzzy sock is not leaving this house anytime soon.
Oh, see, I asked you if you had a match.
I didn't know.
Here, cool. We found one fuzzy sock.
That sock is never leaving this house.
You don't have any of these other socks though?
No.
Are these Maddie's or yours?
Maddie's.
Okay, that's what I thought. This is your old sock, right?
Yes.
Okay.
I've had those socks for a long time, so...
Yeah, you have, so yeah. We... Lord knows where the other one is.
That's why I...
And even these, like, these little mini socks are so cute. I don't know where everything went. So, anyway, I have a little basket, and we just keep it... I keep it over there with the other non, you know, random stuff that don't belong. And as we do laundry, believe it or not, like, Emmy and I just found a whole bunch of pairs in here. Probably like five or six of these pairs had the missing sock in here. So that's, I just leave them here. And you know what? I may even, no, because we don't, I was going to say I'll put them in the laundry room, but we don't ever fold clothes in the laundry room. It's always in the bedroom. So we're getting things put away. Autumn's clothes. I found I need one more pair of shorts and an outfit for Disney for her. We got that stuff put away. Emmy is drawing all the characters to give to them at Disney.
I need to see where I can find the other.
And I'm just kind of going through Autumn's room and downsizing some of the stuff that she has, like her bows. I'm going to keep the newborn bows just in case for the future, but she does not wear newborn bows anymore. We just have so many pretty ones, but they're taking up so much room on her thing. She mostly wears regular bows now, so that's where we're going to transition to. So, yeah, look at all the socks we found, baby.
Mommy, can you help me?
In laundry. Hold on, baby. Hold on. Look, and I mean, we still have a whole bunch left over, but... All of them. So I'm refilling. I feel like I'm not 31 years old. I feel older than that. But I have this pill container that I got from Dollar Tree. They have a whole bunch of different kind of Dollar Tree too. And I was talking about the types of vitamins and things that I'm taking. And so this, I thought I would show you guys. Vitamin D. This was from my primary care physician, but you can buy vitamin D over the counter. It's just not, they can give you stronger stuff at the doctor. I actually have one that my OB gave me while I was pregnant with Autumn that is a once a week vitamin D. So once I run out of those, I may go back to taking that. L-lysine, 1,000 milligrams. Biotin, this is 10,000. This is what I had when I had postpartum hair loss, so I'm just finishing them up. I'll probably go down to the regular normal strength once that's over. And then a woman's one a day. And these are just from Costco. So I pop in all my pills today. I already took them. It's Sunday, so I pop them in for the rest of the week. And then on Saturday when I take my last one, I'll move on to the next day and refill until, you know, every time I run out, I fill for the days after because I don't want to later be like, did I take my pills? And forget. So I leave, once I take them, I leave that day empty and refill the other ones. And then I'm having some nuts for a snack. So fun, super fun afternoon. It's a good thing we didn't go to the water park. Hey, I think a fly just flew by.
What?
I don't know if it was outside or if it was in front of me.
Oh.
Man, those are like huge raindrops, huge. Did I let it in?
No.
Oh. Look at the mermaid out there on the floor.
And the family. Did you draw the family too?
Mm-hmm. I draw you. You and mommy getting ready for a wedding.
No. Oh, it's a mosquito. Is that a mosquito? I don't know what it is, but it's outside. Dang! Good thing you went potty, Beta. Good thing you went potty. Huh. Try and get Autumn awake. She's still passed out. She's been asleep like over 3 hours. Been waiting for her to wake up so we can go have dinner at my brother's house, but hi, Mama. Good morning.
Say Bubba.
Oh, why do you keep pointing at over there? Sophia?
Yeah,
do you show everyone? Say, look at the Sophia on my wall, guys. And your bear? Can I see your bear? Where's your bear?
It's you.
No, the socks. Where's your bear? Where's Autumn's bear? Where is she? Where's Bear? No, you don't want to show us. You ready to get up? Let's go. Let's go. Yay. The day was not lost for nothing. We came over to Chubby's to have dinner. I think we're doing spaghetti. And it's raining. So much for the water park today. It was a chill day. We got stuff done at the house. My mom's over here for dinner as well. So I brought her shirt. She needed something to sew, remember yesterday? So I brought that for her.
I put them in the bag. I didn't have time. Hi,
Mama.
It was just me.
It's a book. It's Paw Patrol.
She was 4 and he was
no, crazy.
Yeah, and he was 1.5 or whatever.
Ooh. Paw Patrol.
Most of the time they enjoy playing together.
Press 1.
When it comes to bath time.
Look, when you think.
Go get more.
Will you put it away?
No.
Oh, that's my shoe. Good job. Got a lot of stuff done today, even though it doesn't really seem like it. I laid out all my outfits. I'm trying to figure out if we need more luggage because the way that I have it right now, we have my three-piece pink luggage, the hardbacks, the one that you see out there. This one. We have
It's a Delsey. I don't know. We got it a long time ago. I feel like we got it before, right after our honeymoon last year, because we had different pink luggage that I got when I went on my senior trip to high school in high school, and it was soft pink, like a baby pink, and it didn't have, it wasn't spinner luggage, so it just had the wheels on the back and you had to, you know, tilt it and pull. And we took that, I remember, on our honeymoon, and it kept falling over and it was just a big old mess. So we invested in these. We got them from the outlet. I want to say they were like maybe 130 or 115 or something like that, and it came in a three set, the large one, the medium one, and then this is technically a carry-on. I don't know the inches on them though, but I actually have taken this as a carry-on before and it barely fits in the carry-on little thing. So I don't know what that tells you. I guess it depends on who you fly with. We fly Southwest most of the time, or American Airlines. American Airlines is a little more strict with their luggage. Southwest is like, ah, whatever, because you can check two bags per person for free. So we were trying to get it with just these three luggage. Well, this little tiny one is already completely full, and it has all of our extras that we're bringing from home. Glow sticks, autograph books, hats, our magic bands, our what else, like necklaces with the pins on them. It has a whole bunch of stuff. I showed you guys that. I packed that weeks ago, or a couple weeks ago. So I was gonna try and just fit everything in there, but it's too small. So we were considering investing in a larger, just one more large, not the whole three pack, just one large spin suitcase, so that the girls could help us push it. And then we would have the large pink, the medium pink, and a large whichever other one, so that we could have more room. Plus, we're bringing our Hawaii luggage, which is a traditional soft, like, pull, tilt and pull luggage that has snacks, travel snacks, and it's going to be completely full. Travel snacks and then park snacks and things like that. Things that I don't have to buy. I told you that I can buy in bulk here for so much cheaper. I have read so many things about the Publix, the Walmart. Everything is so much more expensive over there. I don't know if that's true. If you guys are from Florida, definitely let me know. Because if it's not, well, I mean, I guess if you've never been to Texas, our prices are very reasonable here. The cost of living is very reasonable compared to Florida. So I can only imagine what all the stuff I have in my Hawaii suitcase would cost over in Florida. So I got as much as I could here, and then I took from our pantry. My mom ordered some stuff, things like that. So our intent is to eat all that while we're over there for snacks. That way we don't have to buy a whole bunch of stuff over there. And we'll have an empty suitcase on the way back, either for dirty clothes, for souvenirs. You know, nothing ever fits back in the suitcase the way that it did when you brought it over. So anyway, today I was trying to get a feel for how many outfits I had, how much clothes, or how many pieces of clothing I was going to take, whether I could fit them in my cubes, all that good stuff. Because I have all three girls in the medium pink suitcase, and it's full to the brim. I can't even shut it. When I put their shoes in, I can't even close it. So I was like, oh no. I was planning on putting their toiletries in there, their shoes, and all of their clothes, and I'm still missing a couple outfits for them. Luckily, all their swim stuff, their jammies, all that stuff is in there, but I still have to pack so much stuff. And again, those of you, it's so funny because I'll have to tell you in a minute when I can turn the camera around, but this is what I have laid out so far. So I have 7 full outfits, and then I have a couple, I think I brought 3 more pairs of shorts, jammies, my bathing suit, and then I just need a couple more shirts. So pretty much on the way up there and the way back, I'm just going to dress comfortably. And then I need 10 full outfits. So I have 2 more shirts that I need to buy, Animal Kingdom and Hollywood Studios. So I was going to get a Star Wars shirt and a Lion King shirt from Torrid. And then, well, I'm kind of up in the air. I was going to get the Torrid one, which has the Simba symbol that Rafiki draws on the wall with his thumb. I was going to get that, but then I was thinking about doing an iron-on for Animal Kingdom. I haven't decided yet. I need to get going, though, because we're literally leaving in 3 weeks. But I laid out all my stuff. Andres is so funny. He was like, oh my gosh, look at all that stuff you have. I'll probably have 2 pairs of shorts and like 5 shirts, and he'll just rotate. I can't help it. What can I say?
It's so hard to pack for, because he, I mean, bless his heart, I love him to death, but he's my heavy lifter. He moves things for me. He does not pack. Never has. As many vacations as we've been on together, he only ever packs his own clothing. He never packs toiletries, he never packs my stuff, the girls' baby, like even when they were babies, he's never ever packed. I don't know, is that how most husbands are? He's just never packed, even if he has time. That's just not his thing. Organizing, planning outfits out, no telling what those children would look like if he had to plan out outfits. No telling. So yeah, he just has never done that. So it takes me a while. Like, I still have to figure out where, I guess I could, you know what, I probably will have put in my order diapers, because I was thinking, where am I going to put Autumn's diapers? I don't even have enough luggage for that. And my point is like, we're traveling with two car seats, one for Autumn, one for Maddie, like full car seats, a booster for Emmy, which I'm probably going to take her bubble bum and throw it in my bag. I think that'll be the easiest. I mean, we're going to have a stroller, a double stroller, our carry-on luggage, so it'll be like my bag, purse, or whatever I'm taking, and then plus I'm bringing one carry-on like bag full of their activities, their electronics and things like that. And we're going to end up having four pieces of luggage. Four. Now, one of them is full with food, so technically three for just my family, because it's too hard. I don't know how. I mean, I guess maybe I'm overpacking clothes. I don't know. It's too hard for me to pack all of them into one suitcase. And Andres and I share a suitcase, but we still have to do toiletries. We're going to be gone for 12 days. Toiletries and shoes and all these little things that I'm bringing to try and save money. Thank goodness Southwest does not charge for luggage. If they charged for luggage, we for sure would not be bringing all the extra stuff. And I called to see if we could ship some stuff down there so we didn't have to haul everything on the plane. And the hotel that we're, the resort that we're staying at, will let us ship, but they charge $10 for an item to be shipped there if it's under 10 pounds. If it's over 10 pounds, it's $10 plus a dollar for every pound that it's over. So I'm like, okay, well that stinks. If we send all of our snacks, let's say, you know, that's $50, $60, depending on how much we send. That defeats the purpose of taking it on a plane for free. You know, that's the only reason. If we had to pay for the luggage, I totally would be buying everything over there, because the cost of the luggage would make up for how much the cost difference in food prices. So yeah, I was telling Andres today, I was like, I feel very alone. No one is helping me plan. No one is helping me pack. I feel alone. Alone. But I feel good getting it done. And I had to laugh. This is what I was going to say earlier. We went over to Chibi and Melissa's tonight for dinner, which was very good. He made spaghetti. And it just reminded me how much I need either a crock pot or a pressure cooker back in my life. Seriously, because he had made the sauce in the pressure cooker and it was so good. But I told him, and I hadn't had like regular pasta in so long, and I had a little bit of spaghetti with, and then when I went back for seconds, I just had the meat sauce. So I tried to do better. It was really good. But they're leaving for California in like 2 weeks. I don't even know that it's a full 2 weeks. I think they leave the very beginning of June, maybe even the first or second. I don't know. But they're leaving very soon for California, and they haven't packed at all. Like, not even set stuff aside. None of it. Because when you're just packing for yourself, it's totally fine to do it a day or two before, or the day of if you leave later in the day. It's not a huge deal. In the past, I've done that. But when you're having to pack for four people plus part of your husband, because all he'll pack is his clothes, that's really hard. It takes a long time to sit down. And that way I only have to think about it in small increments. I don't have to spend, you know, hours and hours packing at once. So anyway, that's what I've done today. Because it was raining, we had planned to go to the water park, but it was raining all day, so I didn't have a choice. We had to kind of stay in. So anyway, I'm going to call it a night. I'm going to lay down. It's 9:41. Vlog is uploading. I have an early appointment with the personal trainer tomorrow, and I don't think I have anything else planned. I could be wrong. Let me see. Nope, just a trainer. So I may come back, and the house is clean. The girls' rooms look good. I mean, there's really not much housework that I need to do. I guess I could do a load of laundry, but there's not really too much housework. So if I'm feeling uppity, I may go to Walmart and get a few more things. If not, I may just chill here all day. We'll see. I don't know. I washed my hair today because it was feeling, I don't know, kind of gross. And so then afterwards I was like, I'm gonna be working out tomorrow. That's probably not the smartest idea, but that's okay. So anyway, I'm going to call it a night. Hopefully you guys enjoyed today's vlog, and we'll see you tomorrow. Oh, and I wanted to say one thing. about going to work full time, I was reading the comments and things like that, and so many of you were like uber disappointed that I'm even considering going back to work more. But I wanted to clarify this. First off, wouldn't even happen until school starts, because the whole reason for me going back to work is so I can justify putting Maddie in private preschool full time. Right now she's part time. I don't know that I want her going to a non-private preschool that's free, because a lot of them are ESL, which there's nothing wrong with that, but I just don't want anything. I don't want her to be held back, because the other kids are they have to learn English, or a good majority of it, before they start kinder in Texas, so that they can learn and they're not held back. So I don't know that I kind of want to keep her in private preschool. Because of that, there's more of a cost associated with it. And I was considering, if I do go back to work, putting Autumn in daycare part-time. So, and actually she would be at the same preschool that Maddie's at, just in a lower level. So I don't know. I haven't decided. If I wait till she's two, she'll go to the preschool side of it instead of the daycare side of it. If I don't wait till she's two, she'll transition at some point. But that was my main thing for thinking about doing that. And if I do that, then it would allow more funds to go towards things like that. But I haven't decided yet. I'm still so tossed up. Some days I'm like, yes, I want to work more. And some days I'm like, oh, I love being at home with them and being able to be here for everything that they do and all that good stuff. So then my medium compromise was going back to work maybe 2 days a week instead of full time. That may be an option. And even some of you guys suggested that. That may be an option. So we'll have to see. I don't know. Regardless, it won't happen until the school year begins. So nobody worry too much. I know a lot of, I even got messages on DMs on Instagram like, please don't go. And I love you guys so much for that. And even if I do go back to work, even full time, I still would continue to vlog. I just wouldn't vlog on the days that I work. So you guys will still see me. I'm not going anywhere. It's just more of something I may need to do for myself, but we'll see. Because like I said, when I was working full-time, all I did was complain that I was working full-time and I didn't get to spend more time with the girls. And now that I have that, I'm not feeling like I'm contributing as much, even though I contribute more than what I did before. Does that make sense? So I don't know. I think it's just an internal battle I'm having with myself. Probably next week I'll be like, oh, I love staying at home. I don't want to go back to work full time. So nobody worry too much just yet, okay? I just sometimes when I talk to you guys, it's like word vomit. Everything that's in my head comes out, because I don't always have another adult to talk to. And I always assume, even though you guys are all ages, all races, nationalities, genders, all everything, I feel like I'm talking to another adult. Another friend, and it doesn't really matter how old you are, I guess, because I've had little ones message me, men, women, you know, all kinds of couples, all kinds of things, but I feel like when I'm talking to you guys, I feel like I'm talking to my best friend, you know, like that's how I feel. And so it's so easy for me just to be like, oh, well, I'm thinking about this, I'm thinking about that, and it just kind of comes out before I really even am like, nothing's settled yet. So nobody worry, nothing's happening yet. Just wanted to give you guys a heads up. So I've been chatting way too long. I will let you guys go. I hope you enjoyed. We'll see you tomorrow.